Welcome to the course Introduction to R Programming. In this lecture, I am going to discuss about sorting and ordering, which is part of data management. Coming to outline, first we will see the introduction about sorting and ordering. Then we will see the syntax and examples of sorting. Finally, syntax and examples of ordering. Now we'll see the introduction. First, what is sorting and what is ordering? That means how to sort a data and how to order the data, or how to know what is the order of the data. These questions are raised for all. So whenever we heard about sorting and ordering. So now coming to the exact meaning, sort means rearranging all those values, whatever the values, in an increasing order of magnitude or decreasing order of magnitude. For example, we have a vector with different magnitudes, different values with a different range, not in one particular sequence. So all are jumbled. So whenever you can apply sort, those can be rearranged either in continuously increasing order or continuously decreasing order. Increasing order means least value to highest value, and decreasing order means highest value to least value, like that. So that is meaning of sorting. Similarly, when we say that we want to order the data, that means we need to know what is the order value of a particular value inside the vector. So this order can be applied for the variables or the vectors. So based on a particular range value, the order can be defined. That is the difference between sort and order. Now we will see the syntax of sort. See, the sort function sort the values of a vector in ascending order. See, by default the sorting can be done in ascending order without providing ascending or descending order. If you want to sort the data in descending order, you need to mention the order. So the order function sorts a variable, whereas order function sorts a variable according to the order of the variable. This is the difference between sort and order. Sort function sorts the values of a vector, whatever the values in the vector, either in ascending order, that is by default, or descending order. Whereas order function sorts the variable. Here you can see sort function sorts the values, where order function sorts a variable according to the order of the variable, whatever the order you can provide. That is the difference between sort and order functions. Then coming to sorting, the syntax of sorting in R software is given below. Just now we mentioned what is use of sorting. Sort function sorts the values of a vector in ascending order by default or descending order. The syntax is, here we have two forms. The first one, by using the command sort, sort as a command within brackets. First, you can provide the data x, comma, decreasing equal to false. So whenever you can provide decreasing equal to false, so the data can be sorted in increasing order. Comma, some other arguments. This is one simple form of sort function. The second form is so sort of x, comma, decreasing equal to false, then na dot lost. So not available dot lost equal to not available, and so on. Like multiple arguments are there. Now we will see what is meaning of each and every argument. Here, where x denotes vector of values to be sorted, whatever the values that can be stored in x, those can be sorted. Here, decreasing parameter, what is use of decreasing? So it should sort the data in increasing or decreasing order. So based on the true or false, whenever you can make decreasing as true, then that can be sorted in decreasing order. Whenever you can make decreasing as false, then that can be sorted in decreasing false means that can be sorted in ascending order by default. Then NA dot last equal to NA not available. So this can be used for controlling the treatment of NAs not available values. So here three cases. If true, if NA dot last is true, missing values in the data are put last. What are the missing values that can move to the end? So whenever NA dot last equal to false, so the values that those are all placed at starting. Then whenever NA dot last equal to NA, so not available means they are removed based on true, false, NA, three values. If it is true, missing values can be moved to last. If it is false, missing values can be placed at first. If it is NA, missing values can be removed. These are all the three values of NA dot last. So these are all the various forms of syntaxes of the sort command. Now we will see examples. First, you can take data that can be stored in a vector named it as y. Y equal to c of 8, 5, 7, 6. These values are stored in y. Then you can call y. Then you are sorting y. Simply you can use y inside the sort function. By default, this can be sorted in the increasing order. That means ascending order. So sort of y. So what y contains 8, 5, 7, 6. This is not in any order. The order is either decreasing or increasing, not any one of these order. This is combination, jumbled. Now, whenever you can use sort of y, by default, the data that can be sorted in increasing order, that means ascending order. Now you can see from the data 8, 5, 7, 6, first takes the lowest value. Lowest out of 4 is 5. First is 5. Next, after 5, next higher value is 6. After 6, next higher value is 7. Then after 7, higher value is 8. So increasing order. The sorting can be done here in the increasing order, also called as ascending order. So that means lowest value to highest value. Then another way, if you want to sort in descending order or decreasing order, you can use the command like this. Sort of y comma, you can provide decreasing equal to true. If decreasing equal to true means you can, the sorting can be done in the descending order or decreasing order. Decreasing order means highest value to lowest value. From the y, 8, 5, 7, 6, first takes highest value is 8. So after 8, next lower value is 7. After 7, next lower value is 6. After 6, next lower value is 5. So highest to lowest, that is a decreasing order. So again, if you want to sort in increasing order or ascending order, two methods. Directly you can use sort of y. By default, that can be sorted in the increasing order, or by specifying decreasing equal to false. Decreasing equal to false means that can be sorted in the increasing or ascending order. Now, this is the execution screenshot. So after executing this command using our R software. Now we will also run these commands and see the demonstration. So first you can take the vector. You can take the vector not in increasing sorting order, either ascending or descending. You can take random order. So here y equal to c of whatever the values 8576. See, these are all the values not in increasing order or decreasing order. So here no order is followed. Now you can call y. What it contains 8576. Simply by using sort command, you can call that vector sort of y. By default, the vector that can be sorted in the increasing order. So if you want in the decreasing order, sort then use the function decreasing. So whenever you can give decreasing as true. Now this can be sorted in the decreasing order, means highest value to lowest value. See, highest is 8, so lowest is 5, so 8, 7, 6, 5. Again, if you want in increasing order, you can make decreasing as false. So again, it can be sorted in the increasing order or ascending order. So that is the use of sorting function to sort the data from the vector either in increasing order or decreasing order. By default is increasing order. If you want specifically decreasing order, you can use decreasing equal to true. Then coming to the second function, ordering. So we already seen the purpose of ordering. So order function sorts a variable according to the order of the variable, whereas sorting that can sort the data from the vector. So here also that order can be either in ascending or descending order. So while coming to syntax of ordering, here also two forms are there similar to sorting. The first one is, but you can use the command order within bracket x comma decreasing equal to false. That is one form. The second form, order of x comma decreasing equal to false comma na dot last equal to true, etc. Some other arguments. So see the explanation of each and every parameter of the function order. So where x is same as sorting, vector of values to be sorted, whereas decreasing, should the sort be in increasing or decreasing by using this decreasing command. Then na dot last, so which controls the treatment of not available values. Here also the same three cases as in sorting. The first one is if true means missing values in the data are put last. If false means they are put first. If na means they are removed. So same purpose here also, na dot last and decreasing. But the only command order is used that can be used to sort a variable according to order of the variable. Now here you can see one example. First, here we are taking one vector, now y equal to c of some data. Previously, whatever the data, same is considered 8 comma 5 comma 7 comma 6. Then you can see the vector, what it contains, simply enter the vector name y. Now the data is stored in y. So whenever you can apply order of y, simply you can call order within bracket, call the vector name. So then you can see this is the output 2, 4, 3, 1. So how this output is given? Here you can see the explanation, it is very important. So first the data, whatever the data in the vector, that can be placed in one order, whatever the order. See, the first value is 8, the second value is 5, third value is 7, sixth value is, fourth value is 6. So this you can make it as a place 1, place 2, place 3, place 4. By default, whatever the given data, positions are indexing. So now, here order of y means by default, here also increasing order. So increasing order means actually what is the output? The lowest value to highest value. 5 is the lowest value. Next highest is 6. Next highest is 7. Next highest is 8. But here our output is not like 5, 6, 7, 8. So it provides the order of the variable, not order of the data. So what is the order of the, what is the variable here? Y is the variable. Then what is the order of the Y? So what is original order of the Y? So this is original order, 8, 5, 7, 6 is the original order. So now you can take the increasing order sequence, find their place or order, that value is displayed. Our first increasing first value is 5. So fifth one can be at which position, which place, that is second place. So its order is 2. So address simply displays the address. So 2 is the address of 5. The next increasing value is 6. Sixth will be in the variable y, will be at which position, that is fourth place. So the address or index is 4. So next value is 4. Next increasing order value is 7. So seventh value will be at which place? C1, 2, 3, third place. That means its address or index is 3. So 3 is displayed. Then finally, next increasing value is 8. So 8 will be at first position. Its address is 1. So in the increasing order, whatever the values, that values position from the variable y can be displayed as the output. That we will call it as address. Now the address is 2, 4, 3, 1. So that is the output here. Here carefully you can observe. Whenever you can use order of y, the order of the variable address will be displayed here. Similarly, this is by default increasing order or ascending order. Then if you want to demonstrate in decreasing order or descending order, you can use same as sort function. A decreasing equal to true you can give. So order of y comma decreasing equal to true means first it takes a descending order sequence. The original data 8576 in descending order. So descending, the original data is not in decreasing order or descending order. So first you can sort into descending order, it means highest to lowest. So first highest value is 8, next lower value is 7, next lower is 6, next lower is 5. So highest to lowest. Now in this order it gives the address. Now what is the address of 8? So address of 8 will be 1. Place 1 means address 1. Next 7th value address is 3. So that position is 3. Then 6th value address is 4, 4th place. Then 5th address is 2, 2nd place. So 1, 3, 4, 2 is the output. Now you can see 1, 3, 4, 2. So like that, the ordering sorts the variables based on the order of the variable that can be stored initially. There is the difference between ordering and sorting. Now we will also execute this one. Same thing here represented. See, after execution, the output screen is pasted here. Now we will also run. First, take the vector, same vector previous one. So call y. This is the vector. So now you are simply call order of y. So here, just now what we explained, what is order of y means? So by default, the data in y that can be sorted in the increasing or ascending order. Based on that increasing or ascending order, that address will be displayed as the output. Now you can see 2, 4, 3, 1. So 2, 4, 3, 1 means first ascending order, lowest to highest. So your lowest value is 5. So 5 will be in the second position. Next greater than 5 value is 6. 6 will be at the fourth position. Next after 6, next value is 7. 7th value is third position. So after 7, next value is 8. 8 will be at first position. So that address or index will be displayed. So if you want to display the address in decreasing order or descending order, you can provide decreasing equal to true. That means now the sorting can be done in the decreasing order, then their addresses will be displayed from the original stored location in y. Now you can see. So first sort the data 8576 in decreasing order. Descending means lowest to highest. So first you can take 5, then 6, decreasing order, then 7, then 8. If decreasing equal to true, then find their addresses, similar to what we explained earlier. So here the position of the original data location will be displayed here. So earlier what you got 2, 4, 3, 1. Now here 1, 3, 4, 2. See, that is the difference between increasing order index, decreasing order index. So this is use of the order command for sorting of the variables, the data that can be available in the variable order. Okay, that's all about sorting and ordering. It's a very simple concept, only two commands, sort and order. With this, I am stopping. So now we stop here. And you talk some time to practice the sequence, orders and sorting. Sequence we discussed in our previous lecture. Now in this lecture, we discussed about orders and sorting. So try to take some examples from the book or assignment, and some other issues will be discussed in the next lecture. Till then, goodbye. Happy learning.